Mayuresh Joshi joins in, fund manager Angel Broking, with his sense of the market. Since we are talking aviation this morning, Mayuresh, come in with your thoughts and which would be your preferred investment idea, jet, Indigo or SpiceJet?
Morning, Tanvir. So yes, I think the good times probably have started, not in the literal sense. But again, I think aviation stocks probably in a sweet spot. And large element, if you look at Jet's concall, was the reduction of the cost per available speed kilometer. Now, if you look at the ATF prices, they probably remain constant for most airlines. So a large component of the cost, which is around 25 to 30%, probably remains constant. But the cost per available seat kilometer X fuel, if they're able to improve and optimize on that, that does create a significant amount of bearing, because a lot of expenses on the aviation front happen on ATF, parking, lease rentals, depreciation, employee expenses, which eats a lot into their cash flows. But a large element again is the kind of flows that we are probably seeing, both in terms of domestic traffic. If you look at the passenger load factors, they are improving quarter after quarter with the new Udaan scheme that the government has announced, the new infrastructure development that will take place over the next few years, with new airports coming through, the long overall flights, which is a high accretive margin business for most operators, and Jet probably remains a market leader in that. So yes, I think the good times probably in terms of yield improvement probably seen in aviation stocks. Jet has shown a significant movement. What actually comes out of the con call will be very, very interesting. But at this point of time, my own sense is that any decline, looking at the cost structure, at least at this point of time, Indigo is something that I'll continue to prefer.
Mayuresh, give me your top ideas for 2018.
So a large element, Nikunj, will obviously remain with a few stocks within the banking space. So the corporate banking side, again, ICICI Bank is something that I've reiterated. And a large element of that argument still holds in favor. As the next few quarters, you'll probably see the watch list coming down. And as the credit growth environment improves, you're probably going to see traction. On the other hand, with budget around the corner, my entire emphasis lies in terms of greater rural allocation from the exchequer. And if that really happens, because what you've seen in last year's budget in terms of allocation towards farmer, agriculture, welfare, if that increases multifold, my own sense is that a lot of these rural focused stocks will actually start doing well. So I think if you can break it down into rural financing companies, you've already seen huge movement happening on Shriram Transport Finance, M&M Financial, Chola Investments. I think they're expensive at this point of time, but any decline, my own sense is that the kind of credit growth that these companies can achieve, along with stability on asset quality as they move to the 90-day bucket window, that would be very, very interesting themes. On the other hand, I've been very, very selectively bullish on fertilizers as a space as well. So in that, I think Coromandel International is something that I've kept on liking from lower levels. With DBT expected to come through, the kind of erosion that we've probably seen in terms of whatever was expected from subsidy receivables, that component goes down significantly, the debt component goes down significantly, and the volume growth increases the leverage. Again, selective stocks like Rallis, you'd seen a huge movement yesterday. But my own sense is that there will be a very, very decent top line growth. Even a 4-5% on the base is quite decent. Cash rich balance sheet, ROC is in excess of 22-odd%, ROE is in excess of 16%. So that's a very interesting theme. On the specialty chemicals, my own sense is that a lot of noise has been created around China and supply constraints. But that will very well continue, because the effluent discharge concerns that Chinese manufacturers had is not going to abate so very easily. On the other hand, all the new facilities that come up, the compliance and the labor costs go up significantly. So a lot of specialty chemical players actually benefit. So Bodal, Shri Pushkar is something that I've kept on liking. I continue to do so. And yes, you've discussed infrastructure, power, roads. So selectively, I think road players have done exceedingly well. I did like NCC, Ashoka, Sadbhav, KNR. They have moved up significantly, but the traction might very well continue. And within the power side as well, I think a few transmission plays. So something like Kalpathru Power, with rural electrification also gaining a lot of traction. My own sense is that the kind of numbers that Kalpathru has done in the first half, 5-6% top line growth, they can very well do that target of 15-16%, and that will be an exponential performance in the second half. So margins around 9-10%, you're probably looking at an EPS of 26-27 odd rupees for FY19. So any decline on these stocks, I think, become very, very interesting opportunities and themes to look out for FY18.
Okay, just about 4 minutes to go before we step into the actual open this morning. Mayuresh, just wanted a quick perspective on the oil marketing companies. If you could just give us an answer quickly in a minute on what's the positioning there.
So disappointed on GRMs, Tanvir, very clearly, but if you look at the trend that they are probably undergoing, I think marketing margins are expected to marginally increase, which increases their sensitivity to earnings. If you look at the new complexities coming up with expectations of crude remaining between 60-65, the cash flows are very strong, and as these refining capacities come up, the GRMs with Nelson complexities about 10-11 are going to increase significantly the refining margin trend. So I think the hold rating continues on OMC's. Buying, I think you should probably wait for declines, but the hold rating at this point of time continues.
Okay. Fair enough, Mayuresh. Thanks. Mayuresh, we've seen a decent open for the markets, but stepping into 2018, what is it that you're telling clients in terms of the trajectory the markets can take from here, and what should they be wary of in terms of the risks?
So if you map the entire roadmap right from 93 to 2017, the Sensex EPS growth has been close to 12-odd%. So corporate earnings, Tanvir, is very, very critical for the markets to re-rate themselves. And our own premise over the next 2 years is that corporate earnings will grow in that 14-15% kind of range. So in absolute terms, in 93, the Sensex EPS was 82-odd rupees. We ended 2017 in 30-50-odd rupees. So that is the exponential growth that we've seen, and we've seen turmoil toils. Times happening during this period. So any political events, we had economic disruptions, but the markets probably take that into their stride over a longer period of time. Secondly, again, in terms of headwinds specifically that the Indian markets can probably face is the expectations of too much paper coming in, and that equity issuance can probably have some impact on liquidity. And what probably happens in terms of the fiscal map, because what we've seen probably with farm loan waivers, I think the skepticism on that front will continue. However, the government probably has probably embarked that they will still stay on the fiscal path. The third angle, again, I think becomes critically important is the geopolitical and the global developments that are happening. At this point of time, I think everything looks probably in the right direction. Any upheaval there can create some amount of distortions. So we are quite optimistic in terms of return expectations over the next 2 years. However, the kind of returns that the markets have generated over the last 2 years cannot be repeated over the next 2 years unless corporate earnings revive. So the themes, as I said, remain the same. I think selective banking names, selective NBFC names, selective names that focus on the rural areas, specialty chemical names, a very select few auto ancillaries is something that I continue to remain bullish about, city gas distribution companies, and selective on infra, which caters to roads and power. So I think you need to have a bottom-up approach, because valuations probably across sectors at this point of time probably looking a little bit on the higher side.
Okay, Mayuresh, thanks very much for that perspective.